What's up, YouTube? This is Arnell with the All for Love YouTube channel, and we're back with another one with...
Heya!
Miss Angela Pack. So if you remember her, she joined us in our last video where I get constructive criticism for my terrible dancing for my Instagram videos. And the piece that we're going to be reacting to and getting, and for me getting constructive criticism for today, is a piece by the very famous duo of Kevin and Dea. And if you don't know who they are, you're probably living under a rock or you don't know much about dance, and that's okay. Because Kevin is from, he's currently a member of the Kinjas, who's like super popular. And Dea is his now wife. And they make amazing collabs together and stuff like that. And the piece that we're going to watch was one where they, it was the first time they actually taught at Snow Globe in like a very long time. I don't remember the exact time, but I just know it was like the first time in maybe like a year or about. Maybe like a year, maybe, or a little bit less than that. But it was my first time learning from them and taking a class with them. And it was just a lot of fun, but there was a lot of growing pains for me. I would just like to have somebody watch it with me because it's been a long time since I watched this choreography too. And just to get some feedback on how I did. So Angela and I are going to watch the video like now, and then let's see what Angela got for me later. All right, you got the videos, Angela?
Yep.
All right, so let's just watch and see how I did. If you feel anything, you ain't gotta hide. You get a chance to show it all before the night. I was out here talking about how I put it down. You still have. Yo, I like it slow cause I'm from down south. I still wasn't cool and she told me no grass.
Alright,
now there's a couple videos, guys, so we're gonna watch like all three of them. Oh, the memories. Oh, some good, some bad, definitely in there. All right, so after watching that stuff, what do you got for me, Angela? Like, off rip.
I think come on. Your second one was your best one. The second one was the best one out of the three.
Really?
Okay. Unfortunately, it's the one where you were like cut off.
Well, because I was on the edge, and you know, the cameraman is like trying to shoot everybody. I think that was the group with all the boys.
I think the reason why I say that is because it's not like your dancing was like worse than the other two, but it's just like that was the one that you were the most you looked the most confident and the most comfortable in.
Yeah.
Like in the first one, it was way too obvious on your face that you were just like thinking what the next move is going to be, you know, like what's next
because the funny thing is, like, in the first one, like, I personally liked the first one, like the first part, but like when I'm doing like that little roll thing, I thought oh, that looks cool, but then like after that I could tell that I kind of was like just trying to remember the choreography and just like keep up with everyone, because I somehow ended up being in the front. for both of those first two videos. And I normally do depend on like kind of using my peripherals to watch other people around me. So on this one, I was kind of like, I'm by myself. Remember the moon. And stuff like that. But yeah, I can see what you mean though. But what else you got?
I liked how in the last one, even though you made a mistake, you didn't quit. Like, you forgot. There's a moment I could see where you just blue screened. but you kept pushing through, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, it's a workshop, so it's really easy for students, once they blue screen, to just walk off. And just be like, I'll, like, maybe come back next time or something like that. Like, but instead, like, you just kept faking it until you finally got it.
Yeah, because even though, like, because Kevin and Dea, like, they're really advanced dancers, but for this piece, it was really mellow in comparison to other stuff, that intricate things that they've done in the past.
Yeah.
So I knew, even though I was messing up, like, I knew at some point I could probably catch it where it's a little bit easier for me to catch. And, like, because I was just, like, because then you see the video, like, I'm looking at somebody, like, I'm trying, and I'm just, like, all right, where can I pick it up again?
Yeah.
But, yeah, no, I'm actually really proud of myself for that, too, because I was, like, dead center, and I was, like, man, like, if I walk off, that's pretty obvious. If I walk off.
So, like, props for, like, sticking through and, like, being able to, like, pick it up, and if you didn't show it on your face, people wouldn't have been able to tell completely.
Yeah. Like, I know, like, even when I was on the competition team, like, when I did, like, Chapkiss, and, like, and even when we danced in college for Agape, we always preach, like, if you mess up, it's fine, but don't show it on your face. In a workshop setting, though, like, I'm just glad that I at least was, like, laughing at myself about it.
Yeah.
Like, in the third one, like, I wasn't like, oh, crap, you suck.
Yeah.
But I was just more so just having fun. And I give a lot of credit of that to, like, the community that took that class, and Kevin and Dea, because they made it, because their intent was for it to be a fun workshop. So, like, being able to just keep into that vibe despite the mistakes was fun and everything. Wish I hadn't done that, but it is what it is.
It is what it is. I mean, you did fine. I think another thing I would say is that because it's such a fun piece, what I would have liked to see more from you was to be looser, because you're very tight, even on, like, the groovy movements. That's, like, I don't know the choreography, but, like, you know, like, when, I think they're all leaning back, kind of, like, tat, 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 and, like, and stuff. Like, even, like, movements, like, it was still, like, very, like, tight. And, like, and so I feel like with a piece like this, like, if you could just be a little, like, looser, and then, like, just look like you're having more, like, more groove, I guess. I don't know. I mean, you're pretty groovy enough, but, like, just not so controlled.
Yeah. I know what you mean. Like, because there are some moments, like, even when I watch Kevin and Dea do it, like, I mean, they have amazing body control. They've been dancing for, like, years. So, like, they can, like, stop on a dime and then, like, keep going and stuff like that. But there were, like, definitely, like, those parts where that are definitely, like, more groovy and everything, that I took the more safe approach, because I know that, like, I know at least for myself, when I dance, like, when I keep, like, my arms and everything, like, closer to my body, like, I can give off the illusion of being more controlled than when I'm not. But like, when you watch other people, like, even in these clips from the Instagram videos, I remember there's other people in that class that had a little bit more of that natural groove that I still need to, like, work on.
So that's probably, like, my main two things that I would be critiquing for this video is just, like, one, like, even if you mess up, just be more confident. Don't show it on your face, and especially, like, don't show that you're thinking when you're on stage. But also, like, to just, like, go bigger, be a little looser. It's okay to, like, not be so, like, in control. Like, obviously still have body control, like, yes, but, like, don't be as rigid, I guess, or heavy, that's the word, like,
oh, heavy, okay,
like even like the groovy movements, it was kind of like tap, 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 like it was very like heavy.
Ah, gotcha. Yeah.
And then so like, but because this is like a fun one, it should just be like, ha, 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 like, yay, obviously I'm not doing it correctly. But like, just like be more like fun, more free, more loose. And so that's probably my takeaways to you in this one.
Okay. Yeah, that's definitely some good sound advice. And I definitely like for everyone, for anyone out there that's like watching and stuff like that, definitely like take these things to heart too. Like when you're like out there training. When you're in a workshop environment, that's a very safe place to explore and let loose. And oftentimes in classes, like pay attention to what the choreographer wants, because I know that in this class, Kevin and Dea kind of gave us a little bit of freedom to express ourselves in certain moments in the choreography. And I continuously took like the safe approach doing that. Where and I still came across kind of heavy in the more like bouncy, groovier sections. Whereas like in the second clip, like the guy that's taller, like if you watch in comparison, even though he's taller than me, he looks like he's a lot more light on his feet, like and stuff like that. So I would definitely recommend anyone out there watching to like learn from those kind of mistakes that I've made, and like and at the same time like don't beat yourself up too much about it, like I just did. Because it's all, everything is a learning experience.
Mm-hmm. Just like closing remarks is like, this piece was really fun. It was fun to watch too. And so especially for pieces like these, guys, I really encourage Arnel and I encourage everyone else to just really have fun with these kind of pieces. Like, let loose, let wild, be free.
definitely have some great advice, Angela. I appreciate having you again. For one of these videos, who knows, we may see you in a couple more, because there's still a couple videos on Instagram that I know Angela hasn't watched or has probably forgotten about. Hey, I know you, I know you forget, but it's okay. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you guys again soon with another one. Peace,
bye.